NCAA Women's Basketball live on BYU TV, a Thursday night West Coast Conference showcase between 13th-ranked Gonzaga at 16-1, 5-0 in the WCC, taking on BYU 14-3, 6-0 in the West Coast Conference. And we take an updated look at the standings right now. BYU, for the moment, alone on top because they played and won one more game than Gonzaga. Clearly, to date, this is the game of the season for the WCC. Wherever and however you're connected, great to have you with us. I'm Spencer Linton alongside Kristen Kozlowski. Thanks for making us part of your night here on BYU TV. Okay, Kristen, we thought this might happen. Sure enough, the Powers have all won, and now they collide at the top. What do you expect tonight between a very good Gonzaga team and BYU, motivated to win on their home court?
Right. Biggest advantage, they're at home playing in Provo. That is in their favor. But this Gonzaga team is loaded. They come in very disciplined, very experienced, got a lot on their plate that they are able to throw at BYU. The Cougars have to do a great job with these three, the three seniors for Gonzaga. It starts with Zykira Rice, who is having an outstanding senior season, averages 20 points per game in WCC play, but leads them overall at 14.5, shooting the ball very efficiently. Lara Stockton, she's the floor general for this team. She's learned a thing or two from her Hall of Famer dad, John Stockton. She is the calmness for the team. And then Chandler Smith, she can be a streaky shooter. She's an inside-out player, has the range on the perimeter, can also put it on the floor and get to the rim. She's struggling to shoot right now, been in a shooting slump, but she's a player that BYU is very worried about.
The big three for Gonzaga right there will be matched up with the big three on the guard line for BYU. What do you like most about Brenna Chase, Shaylee Gonzalez, and Paisley Johnson?
Well, Chase is the most experienced out of these three, and she brings an edge to her game for BYU. She's first in the WCC in three-point makes per game, averages 3.5 in WCC play on the perimeter, shooting the ball very well, one of the top pesky defenders for the Cougars as well. Gonzalez, top freshman in the league, having an outstanding season so far. She leads this team in points per game and rebounds per game. And then Paisley Johnson, coming off her best performance last week against Pacific and St. Mary's, earned her the WCC Player of the Week.
Our keys to the game presented by Tim Daly Nissan, Tim Daly Auto Group, serving Utah since 1968. We mentioned earlier that Gonzaga has won a program best 16 games and lost just one to open up the season. How do they get to victory number 17 tonight?
It's going to start with their defense. Defend that dribble drive. BYU's guard line, Gonzalez, Johnson, and Chase. We just highlighted them. They're going to put that ball on the floor. They've also got that range. They have to respect their outside shot. And then battle on the boards. Do a good job on the glass with that effort, pursuit of the basketball. Create those extra opportunities for your team. For BYU, on the other side of the court, shot selection is going to be very important. Make shots. They've got to knock down good shots when they get those open looks and dominate the inside. I think the bigs are going to be the best determining factor at how well BYU is going to do in this one. They have to show up and play.
Gonzaga has at least 8 players that average 7 points or more. They love to spread the wealth. Lisa Fortier likes their depth. Now for more on what BYU brings to the table to combat that depth, we bring in Lauren McClain. Lauren?
Spencer, speaking of depth, head coach Jeff Judkins told me that the last time his team had this much depth and balance was in 2014, when his team went to the Sweet 16. He said he has a lot of players that can do a lot of different things. He said he feels comfortable doing what's needed on the court offensively and defensively because he has the personnel to do it. He has a dominant guard line. He has some physical bigs. And if anyone in the WCC is going to give this stacked Gonzaga team a run for their money, it's going to be BYU. Spencer.
That takes us to our Intermountain Healthcare starting lineups, presented by Intermountain Healthcare, keeping the Cougs healthy as the official sports medicine provider for BYU Athletics. Starting for Lisa Fortier's Gonzaga Bulldogs, Zykira Rice, she can do it all. A matchup nightmare is what Jeff Judkins called her. Leanna Wirth, Lara Stockton, Katie Campbell, and Chandler Smith, a veteran squad for Jeff Judkins' BYU Cougars. The starting five now, the aforementioned big three on the guard line, Brenna Chase, Shaylee Gonzalez, and Paisley Johnson. Babalu Ugu will start it forward, as will Shalay Salmon out of New Zealand. We are ready to go in the Marriott Center. Game of the year in the West Coast Conference to date. BYU and Gonzaga. The Cougars have won 8 straight. The Zags have won 12 straight. And the Bulldogs with their highest ranking in program history at number 13. Rice and Ugu jump it, and they will re-cue and do it one more time.
Missed timing, higher toss than I think they anticipated. Maybe some nerves, really wanting to go up and get that ball.
The opening tip-off brought to you by Les Olson Company. Les Olson Company, your office technology partner. Rice and Ugu one more time, and BYU wins the opening tip. Back to Shayla Gonzalez. First place BYU, second place Gonzaga, just a half game behind at 5-0 in those standings. Siri Chalet Salmon, left junction, looking to the post, nothing there. Back to Shayla Gonzalez, and an offensive foul was called as Gonzalez came off the screen. They'll get Salmon for moving, who was not set. And the first team foul on BYU comes 19 seconds into the game.
You'll see the post players for BYU set a lot of those screens, come up high and set the screens. That's going to be a problem. Salmon can't hold still. Gonzalez has to wait.
Here is Chandler Smith, straight away 35 feet away to her right to Laura Stockton, now cycled back to Katie Campbell. Campbell now to her left in the corner. Smith once again, entry pass to Leanne Worth, turning on Ugu. Shaylee Gonzalez down there to help out defensively, and it is off Worth with Gonzalez digging down. Turnover back to BYU.
Well, an outstanding decision by Gonzalez, the freshman. She plays with a high IQ. Recognized that Worth turned her head, and that's when she doubled down.
Gonzalez picked up by Campbell as she comes across half court. Brenna Chase, right wing, open three. That's well long. Long rebound to Paisley Johnson. Zykira Rice down on the floor as well, and Johnson is going to be tied up. The possession arrow points in favor of Gonzaga after BYU won that opening tip. So a good look for BYU. Perhaps some nerves in that shot from Brenna Chase as she overshoots the hoop. And we are still searching for our first points of the game 1 minute in. Laura Stockton picked up by Chase.
I would not be surprised if this is a low scoring game because both these teams very disciplined. They execute the defensive game plan. They're going to start in their traditional man-to-man like we've seen. They'll mix it up defensively. But what they do is they take away each other's strength. So we may have a low scoring game in the 50s or low 60s.
Chase forced Stockton to pick up her dribble earlier than she wanted to, and Stockton dragged that pivot foot for a turnover right back to BYU. Gonzalez now with 15 on the shot clock. No score thus far. Gonzalez off the pick from Ugu. She'll go off the glass and good. She beats her man, Campbell, and then over the top of Leanne Worth. Gonzaga looking to push, and a travel is called as Paisley Johnson gets her feet in front of Chandler Smith.
That is Johnson at her best. She's in the dirty place. She's really trying to be physical, be tough out there, and just stepped right in front of Smith, knowing she was going to catch it and turn and go right into her.
2-0 lead for BYU. Gonzalez defended by Campbell. Entry pass easily stolen by Rice.
Now Rice had great position. Three quarters of front, moved on the air time of the ball.
Stockton works her way inside and draws a foul. She'll go to the free throw line in search of Gonzaga's first points.
No one for the Zags team plays over 30 minutes. She plays deep into her bench. She has four that will come off the bench that could be starters and probably would be starters on other WCC teams. So they are really looking to push the ball. BYU has to get back in transition.
Laura Stockton has not missed a free throw in conference. She's now 11 for 11 in WCC games as she knocks in both of those. 2-2, 8-10 to play in the opening quarter. Shaylee Gonzalez skip past Paisley Johnson, fakes a three. Now she'll go back to Gonzalez, who will reset offensively and now swing it right side to Brenna Chase. Gonzalez now once again. Yo-yo dribble near midcourt. Off the screen of Ugu to Salmon. Salmon gets around Worth, and Stockton is over to try and draw a charge. The officials say she did not get her feet set, and they call a blocking foul, sending Shalay Salmon to the free throw line.
The game plan is to pressure Salmon and Ugu. And so what she does is put that ball on the floor, exactly what she should have done, go to the rim. Stockton was a little late to get there, called for the personal.
Salmon's free throw, long, no good. First substitution of the game comes on the Gonzaga side. Zykira Rice will take a short break. In comes Jen Worth, the twin sister of Leanne Worth, both 6'3 sophomores out of Chandler, Arizona. Salmon's second free throw, rims around and down. BYU takes a one-point lead back here early in the game. Laura Stockton being pressured full court by Brenna Chase. Chase, as is common for this BYU defense, typically draws the best ball handler on the opposing side. And Stockton, working her way down towards the hoop, is fouled once again.
Now this foul is not needed by Ugu. She's just got to step in front, cut off the drive from Stockton, and go straight up. Now she's picked up her second personal.
First free throw once again, perfect from Laura Stockton. And she's got all four Gonzaga points, courtesy of the charity stripe. The Bulldogs lead 4-3.
Stockton's coming off a career-high 19 against Portland. She doesn't put up a ton of points, averages about 8 per game, but she's shooting the ball more confidently and looking to score.
Paisley Johnson, reigning West Coast Conference Player of the Week, drives baseline. This time, a charge is going to be called. And Johnson will be whistled for her first as she got cut off baseline. Good defensive positioning and team defense by Gonzaga. Turning it over is BYU.
And both these two teams lead almost every defensive category in the league. And you see that help side rotation was there in time. It's going to be there. It's just if BYU can beat them to it or make a better play offensively.
Chandler Smith, right junction pull-up, got it. That's a good sign for Smith, who you mentioned has been struggling a little bit recently shooting. For her first shot to go down, confidence is always critical for that shooter's mentality. Shaylee Gonzalez to Chase, cycle to Ugu, driving on Leanne Worth. Ugu off glass, tough move and shot by the freshman.
Well, she has that athleticism to really put the ball on the floor and score. Good footwork by the freshman. Now, if she can keep her wind and stay out of foul trouble, those two fouls, she's got to be smart.
Out of Sao Paulo, Brazil, Babalu Ugu pulls BYU within one. Lara Stockton, wide open, pull-up, short corner jumper from 10 feet, and she's got 6 quick points, picking up right where she left off in a dominant 26-point win over Portland. 8-5 Gonzaga, just over 3.5 minutes into the first quarter. Salmon seeking for position, overcomes Leanne Worth. Jen Worth was fronting Salmon, and the post knocked out of bounds, BYU basketball. Our scorebox sponsor tonight, Brady Industries, a provider of commercial cleaning supplies and equipment. And substitutions in for Gonzaga. Zakira Rice, after about 60 seconds of game time on the bench, is back on the floor. Jesse Loetta is also on the floor for the Zags. Near steal by Stockton. Gonzalez will pull up for three. That's long. Rebound to Chandler Smith. Smith across the timeline, behind the back dribble, has Rice in the post. Rice trying to get around Chalet Salmon. Tough shot. And Gonzalez has the rebound for BYU.
Fantastic from Salmon. Let Rice put it on the floor, take a tough shot, but don't bail her out with a foul. She kept her hands straight up.
Paisley Johnson off the screen of Ugu. Now Ugu at the free throw line, and she didn't set her feet. Traveling, turnover by BYU, back to the Zags.
These are the first substitutions for BYU. We've already played over 4 minutes. Gonzaga's already substituted through their starting rotation other than Stockton.
4 turnovers now for BYU, 3 for Gonzaga. Chalet Salmon will take a break. 6'7" Sarah Hampson into the game. Jasmine Moody also in to replace Babalu Ugu. The starting guards remain for BYU. Jesse Loetta has Worth, left junction, in and out. Rebound tracked down by Hampson. Quickly down the floor to Paisley Johnson, right side. She'll patiently wait for her offense to join her. Brenna Chase goes right back to Johnson. Hampson, high-low, Moody with position. The shot altered by Worth. And Jen does a good job to get herself in position to make that shot a lot harder than it looked like it was going to be for Moody. On the other end, Chandler Smith beats her defender off the dribble and gets to the hoop. 10-5 Gonzaga.
Well, good patience by Smith. No rotation from BYU. And Gonzalez was left out there hanging, trying to catch her from behind. BYU had a nice high-low look, lost possession, but a foul coming from Moody again on that pick-and-roll high screen.
Second time BYU has been called for that specific offensive foul. 4:52 to play in the first quarter. Gonzaga leading 10-5, the 13th-ranked team in America, trying to win their first quarter. Gonzaga leading BYU 10-5, matchup of the top two teams in the West Coast Conference. The Cougars have won 8 in a row, Gonzaga 12 in a row. That is a season best for the Zags, going back to 2014.
And their last loss coming to number one ranked Notre Dame back in November.
The only loss this season, and they played Notre Dame competitively. They also have a win over then 8th ranked Stanford. Zakira Rice, guarded by Jasmine Moody. From the right side, just inside the paint. Scores, make it 12-5.
Just a matter of time before she really gets going, gets more aggressive from that high post. She's so versatile and athletic, very tough to stay in front of.
Loetta with the defensive responsibilities on Shaylee Gonzalez, averaging 17 points a game. BYU offense off to a slow start. Just 5 points in the first 6 minutes. And an entry pass knocked down by Jen Wirth. And another turnover by the Cougars. Laura Stockton into the front court. Fifth turnover. Make it 6 turnovers now for BYU. Lauren, what'd you hear in that BYU timeout as Jeff Judkins tries to calm his team down?
Yeah, Coach Judkins was trying to find something to combat Gonzaga's bigs moving the ball. And that was actually one of Gonzaga's goals coming into this game, is to try and run BYU's bigs a little and pull them out. Also, he said they have 0 assists, 6 turnovers now. They got to move the ball better. Spencer?
All right, we'll look for that. Thank you, Lauren. Jesse Loetta.
And the BYU game plan offensively is to get the ball in the paint. That is something they focused on, but not necessarily their strength. And they're trying so hard to get the ball inside that the guards aren't being aggressive off the attack, doing what they do best.
Sarah Hampson with the block shot on Zykira Rice. Ball falls into the hands of Shaylee Gonzalez. She's tripped up and a foul on Gonzaga. Second team foul on the Bulldogs. And now another substitution for Lisa Fortier. As Jen Wirth takes a break, she had some effective defensive minutes. BYU basketball with Gonzalez. Trying to work the screen of Moody. Free throw line, misses right side. Rebound Stockton, looking to push. 3-on-3, Stockton into the paint, pull up. Good decision, and she scores it.
Well, she got way too deep in the paint. None of the three guards for BYU stopped ball. Picked up ball at half court, and really made her stop, make a decision.
Melody Kempton, the Gonzaga player, to replace Jen Wirth. Gonzalez to Paisley Johnson. Johnson, ball knocked away, back to Jasmine Moody, and she throws it out of bounds. BYU all out of sorts right now. 9-point Gonzaga lead, 14-5, 3:05 to play in the first quarter. And here you see, as you mentioned, Kristen Stockton, nobody stops ball, way too deep.
My guard's retreating. You've got to step up and stop that ball. She's going to go as deep as she can and knock down that shot. She's feeling very confident right now with those 8 points.
Stockton takes a quick breather. Jesse Loetta will take over the point guard duties while Stockton is out of the game. Rice back out to Loetta, who is a very good three-point shooter. That one's long, no good. Kempton rebound, offensive glass, and an easy two. It's a 16-5 lead for Gonzaga.
If Gonzaga does that with the offensive glass, this is where BYU is going to have this lead really stretched down, and they're going to be really chasing them up the mountain. Gonzaga, very good with the offensive glass.
A 14-2 run for the Zags. Over the last 5 minutes, Johnson bailed out on a foul call. That'll go on Chandler Smith. That's her second personal. Fortier wanting an explanation on that call. Smith will likely check out, and we might not see her for the remainder of the first half. Paisley Johnson knocks in the first free throw. That ends the scoring drought.
But BYU needs to turn this corner a little quicker, coming off the screen. They're looking for the roll, which if it's there, hit it. But be more aggressive attacking off that pick and roll.
Johnson right, makes both.
Right now, not shooting well. He's 2-for-6 from the floor. So they've got to do a good job getting the free throw line or creating extra opportunities on the offensive box.
Loetta down low. Kempton, Sarah Hampson over to help out defensively. Her second block shot in the first quarter. Albiero into the game for BYU. To chase, Albiero, left wing, and she didn't set her feet. That's the 8th turnover by BYU.
Now that time she had Moody wide open inside, but chose to put it on the floor, and a turnover. That was the time to hit Moody inside.
That's the storyline of the game thus far. 8 turnovers for BYU, 0 assists. They trail Gonzaga by 9, 16-7. Leanne Wirth. Right junction. Campbell off the screen. Thought about it. Now she'll hand it off to Worth. Gives back to Kempton. Kempton trying to go behind the back, and there's a turnover. Jasmine Moody credited with the steal.
Moody's a fantastic matchup for Townsend, who's very aggressive, very strong player for this team.
Albiero to Paisley Johnson. Now to Chase. Chase, good lob pass inside to Moody, who had position, with Leanne Worth fronting her. That is about as perfect a lob entry pass as you can throw.
Right, and it was effective because of the ball movement. They had a little bit of a reversal, and that's when you're going to get that open duck in or the open lob look.
16-9. Loetta It's Alviero off the dribble. Creates an open three-point shot for Campbell, and she knocks it down. The junior out of Oxnard, California, gives Gonzaga a double-figure lead at 19-9.
Campbell is a three-point specialist. You cannot lose sight of her. She's now hit a three-point shot in 16 straight games.
Johnson, she'll try and answer straight away three. Back rim, no good. Rebound, Leanne Worth, as she holds off Moody. Kempton momentarily. Now over to Jesse Loetta. Leanne Worth from Loetta. Cycled to Kempton, right wing. Campbell off the screen of Worth. Now goes to Worth, who will look to drive left on Moody. And they're going to call a travel on Worth.
BYU doing a good job with their defense, not bailing out the post when they do drive in there. That's something they focused on in practice, is going straight up. Moody and Hampson giving BYU some good minutes right now inside.
Five turnovers for Gonzaga after that most recent traveling call. About a two-second difference between the game clock here in the first quarter and the shot clock. Gonzalez on the wide, just across midcourt. Off the screen of Hampson. Has Moody, short corner left, open jumper, back rim no good. Rebound to Lara Stockman, who's back into the game. 10 seconds to play in the first quarter, 10-point Gonzaga lead. Has Campbell open, right wing three, back rim. Albiero and Chandler Smith battling. Smith throws it up, rebound Hampson as the first quarter buzzer expires. Good start for the 13th ranked Gonzaga Bulldogs, leading BYU in Provo by 10. Cougars trying to slow down a team that's won 12 straight games. Plus in three of her last four games. 2 points here tonight. Gonzaga with a balanced effort scoring in the first quarter. They had five different players put up their 19 points, led by Lara Stockton with eight.
Almost tied BYU's nine in that first quarter. I think the biggest difference is BYU shot selection. Gonzaga's doing a better job being patient, really working the ball and taking good shots. BYU forcing it a little bit.
Cougars have committed eight turnovers as well. Alviero, that shot way off, wide right. And the air ball goes out of bounds to Gonzaga. Pressure defense from the Bulldogs causing BYU all types of problems. Now the Bulldogs will look to capitalize with their senior point guard, Lara Stockton. Looking for Campbell. Alviero does a good job to force her away from the hoop. Campbell crosses over to her left, now to Chandler Smith, right wing. Leanne Worth, free throw line, drives right, cut out by Moody. Good up and under move by Leanne Worth. And it's 21-9 Gonzaga.
Great footwork. She just stayed patient down there, gained that territory, a little bit of an up and under. Moody did a good job staying straight up, but an even better offensive shot.
Brenna Chase, step back three-pointer. Big shot for BYU and Brenna Chase.
Much needed. Her first points of the game take some pressure off of these guards because they have to carry it here in this one. I feel like the posts are doing a pretty good job defensively, but offensively, the guards have to get going for BYU.
Jen Worth forced underneath the hoop. Finds Lara Stockton to bail her out. Katie Campbell will push Chandler to the post and dribble to that left wing with eight on the shot clock. Smith flashing high straight away, driving on Alviero. Chandler Smith is fouled with 5 seconds on the shot clock. They'll get Alviero as we take one more look at that step back three-pointer from Brenna Chase.
Got a lot of extended range. Using that little step back dribble to gain her extra space to get her shot off.
First team foul on BYU. It is on the floor, so Gonzaga will inbound. On the baseline with Lara Stockton. Flips it into Genworth. Stockton gets it back right corner. Entry passes Ikira Rice. Triple team. Ugu digging down, and it looks like she got Rice on the wrist. Jeff Judkins not happy, but I'm pretty sure the contact was there.
Triple teaming Rice down there, and this is going to be the third foul for Ugu. We don't need it. Watch right here. She reached in first, then went straight up, and that's where they're going to call her for the foul. Just go straight up. Just present three tall trees and make her shoot over you.
Zakira Rice, good on the first free throw, and Gonzaga once again with a double-digit lead at 22-12. 8:25 to play in the second quarter. Rice, the senior out of Tacoma, Washington, one of three big-time seniors in this Gonzaga team, and an offensive rebound will be ruled off of Chandler Smith. She had it in her hands, BYU scrambling, and Smith is going to have a fingertip knock that out of bounds. BYU basketball. Zykira Rice, again, part of the big three for Gonzaga. Lauren McLean, what can you tell us about the young lady who rocks that blue hair?
Gonzaga's coach, Fortier, told me that her three returning posts in general have great mid-range ability as well as around the basket, which makes them dangerous. But Rice is so physical. She plays patient, and she goes through her progression. She said all the bigs are working on making the reads, and they keep it simple. They'll look first to their primary move. If it's not there, they'll go to their second, and they work really well together. Spencer.
All right, speaking of that physical play, Rice, block shot out of bounds. BYU off the inbound. Three-pointer is missed from Brenna Chase, but an offensive rebound tracked down by Jasmine Moody. Here's Shaylee Gonzalez, who has been quiet thus far, just 2 points for a freshman of the year candidate here in the West Coast Conference. Gonzalez will step into a three straight away. Gonzalez misses left side, and the rebound tracked down by Jenworth. She has her point guard, Laura Stockton.
Well, back to Zakira Wright. She's a player that is really stepping in and taking on that load offensively. When they need shots, she's able to score them. And last year, she benefited from Jill Barta getting the ball, getting all the attention. Now she's getting the attention and still scoring and creating and doing things. I mean, she has an electric personality to match that hair, and she's quite the player here in her senior season.
Well, we knew Gonzaga would be very good, but you had to wonder, well, what kind of void will Jill Barta leave?
Right.
Because she did everything. And the Worth twins, coupled with Rice's impactful play, have taken over very nicely, clearly, as the Zags are off to their best start in program history.
Well, there's such balance, and they have that inside-out game, share the basketball, executing everybody the potential to put up double figures.
24-12, the Zags doubling up BYU right now, and they're going to call a foul on Stockton. And that'll be her second personal foul. 7:10 to play in the second quarter.
Stockton reached in right here. This is where I thought the foul was. Also with the body. Good cut by Johnson. Little pass to Gonzalez. Need more of that. They need to slash away from the ball. Get more movement.
Paisley Johnson left wide open, as Jill Townsend had cut her off on the baseline but slipped down just for a moment. So Johnson taking advantage. Knocks in the eight-footer, 24-14.
Well, I think that's a great example of how much BYU is trying to do so much of the game plan rather than just read your defense. When your defense falls down, take that shot. She caught herself wide open.
Townsend to Kempton. Kempton driving on Shalay Salmon and step through. Partially blocked shot. BYU looking to run and to cut into this 10-point lead. Brenna Chase. Open Paisley Johnson three, left side, back rim no good, and a rebound to Chandler Smith. But they're going to get Kempton for bodying up on Salmon and call a foul on the floor.
Salmon and Moody, two of the most physical posts in this conference. And talking to Coach Fortier, she said, we have our work cut out to keep them off the glass, to really push them out because they're so physical. That time Kempton picking up the foul, trying to keep her off the glass.
6.5 minutes to play in the first half. Gonzaga with a 24-14 lead on BYU. Shaylee Gonzalez inbounding, baseline right. She'll get the ball back from Sarah Hampson and step into an open three-pointer. That's long. Offensive rebound to Jasmine Moody. Back out to Paisley Johnson. Now Brenna Chase. And again, cycle back to Gonzalez. Calls for the screen from Hampson. Nothing there. So Johnson will dribble straight away. Back to Gonzalez, left side. Entry pass for Hampson is knocked out of bounds by Melody Kempton.
Kempton, 6'1" freshman, battling Sarah Hampson in there at 6'7", really trying to keep her from getting that ball. And BYU looking for the lob pass. So when you're in front and you're fronting the post, you have to continue to battle until that ball is secure.
Gonzalez to Paisley Johnson, no good. Another offensive rebound by Moody out to Chase. Open three, that's going to be short. And now the Zags, after BYU had three separate opportunities to score, could not do it. Grab that rebound, and Chandler Smith is into the lane. Block shot by Chase. Chase with Loetta chasing. Throws it up off the glass, no good. And free throws coming for Brenna Chase. Loetta asking for an offensive foul, said Chase pushed off.
A lot of contact. Chase kept going at her, and I love that physical play from her. The toughness trying to draw this foul. Watch right here. This is a foul. Clearly a foul. I didn't see the extension of the arm that she wanted. But Chase is one of those pesky defenders. She's third in the conference in steals per game at 2.6.
Brenna Chase has been running all over the floor, chasing Lara Stockton and Jessie Loetta. Makes one out of two, 24-15, 9-point Gonzaga lead. 5:40 to play here in the first half. And a foul away from the ball.
They're going to get Johnson trying to get in front of Townsend. Townsend did the right thing. She's a taller player. She's got the size advantage, trying to really post her up and get a catch high post and make a move.
Jen Worth will check back in, replacing Melody Kempton. Good inbounds play, and Townsend is wide open. Jill Townsend, the sophomore out of Washington State, scores it from the left side, 26-15 Gonzaga. They have taken control early on, and now they're going to get Loetta with her hands on Gonzalez. And that is the second foul on Loetta, joining Chandler Smith and Lara Stockton, both with two personals here in the first half. Townsend off the screen, easy bucket.
Townsend's got a turn. I like it better. She turns and faces the action, and then she's able to block shots or alter them.
Paisley Johnson inside, dipping underneath the defensive effort of Jen Worth and scoring it off the glass. Paisley Johnson starting to find her offensive rhythm. She's got 6 points in the first half. Leanne Worth. Back up to Chandler Smith, left side. Chandler Smith around Gonzalez, left junction. Didn't get the roll this time. Gonzalez with the rebound. BYU has numbers. 5-on-4 as Johnson will skip that to Brenna Chase. Now the Gonzaga defense is back and collected. Brenna Chase trying to score the scoop shot. Can't do it. Jenworth out of trouble finds Chandler Smith.
Kept her composure, kept that ball moving, and did not travel.
Chandler Smith short on the pull-up. A track meet over the last 3 minutes. Gonzalez, good pass to Paisley Johnson running the floor. Chandler Smith hits the deck, and the lead is cut to 7. That brings out the BYU fans here in the Marriott Center. 26-19, Paisley Johnson with 8 points, the reigning West Coast Conference Player of the Week. Taking the pass from Shaylee Gonzalez to force the Gonzaga timeout. The BYU Cougars have cut the Gonzaga lead down to 7. Thanks to some transition buckets and offensive play of the WCC Player of the Week, Paisley Johnson. She has 8 points on 3 of 7 shooting, made both of her free throws. And with 4:26 to play in the half, it's about time we check in with Lauren McLean one more time. Lauren, what do you have?
Jeff Judkins told me that Paisley Johnson is the energizer bunny on the team. Juddy said she plays hard always, but now the game is slowing down for her. Defensively and offensively, she sees more things than just going full speed and running through a brick wall. He said now she can go around the brick wall. She's become very balanced, and she's just really confident right now. Spencer.
BYU off the rebound. Brenna Chase! And that's 6 transition points for BYU. The latest 2 from Brenna Chase. So it's not Paisley Johnson who's taking a short break, but it's Brenna Chase this time with that energy.
Stockton had to be very careful. She's got 2 fouls, so she retreated a little bit, gave her a little bit more space than she normally would.
3 different Gonzaga players with 2 fouls. 26-21, BYU within 5.
Watch this outlet really quick up the court to Chase, and she's going to push. So if it's a one-on-one situation, Chase is going to take her, see that extra space, because Stockton does not want to pick up that 3rd foul.
BYU on a 9-2 run. They trailed by as many as 12 at 24-12. It's now 26-21. Kempton cycled to Stockton. Driving on Jasmine Moody. Contact, no foul called. Albiero saves it back into Stockton, who was pressuring after she missed the shot. Zykira Rice. Oh, that is a dagger right there, as BYU had all the momentum. Nearly had the stop, and then Rice knocks down a big-time jump shot from the left junction.
She was left open with all the commotion of BYU thinking they had that secured rebound and starting up the court.
Sarah Hampson to Albiero. Open 3 is good. Maria Albiero.
This is her 5th made 3 on the season, and BYU struggling to shoot the 3 ball. 2-for-11 from distance now. That was much needed.
28-24. The Cougars back within 4, and the fans once again excited. Great high-low play as Townsend coming off that pick, finds Zykera Rice rolling to the hoop. Fundamental basketball, 30-24, Gonzaga now leading by six. LBR just knocked down that three. Gonzalez trying to add to it, and she does. Back-to-back threes. BYU's offense has found its groove here in the second quarter. Just 9 points in the opening 10 minutes. They have 18 here, and they have cut the Zags lead to three.
They're taking the open looks, taking good shots when they have them, not forcing the situation.
Rice, and a steal by Chase. Out to Albiero. Two on one for BYU. Albiero offs to Gonzalez, left corner, and now BYU will slow things down and reset. Jeff Judkins calls his play. Signaled into Brenna Chase. Now to her teammates. Chase calls for the screen from Sarah Hampson. Chase hook pass to Hampson. Tried to alley-oop it in. Misses, gets her own rebound, and puts it back in. It's a one-point game in Provo.
One of these times, she needs to go up and just dunk that basketball. A perfect alley-oop pass from Chase, but Hampson stuck with it.
Jen Worth looking on Moody. Spins back baseline side and scores, and a foul. Big time response from Jen Worth.
Here's a look at the steal right here as they pinch in, double team Rice. That's the game plan. And she, Chase recognizing, faces turn, go for that ball. Look at this, just alley-oop, go up and dunk it. Hampson playing well though, and defensively she has been altering shots, doing a good job on the pick and roll, the high-low look.
Sarah Hampson, 2 points, four rebounds, two assists, and three blocks. Worth can't finish the three-point play, but the missed free throw goes for an offensive rebound, trapped down by Townsend. Just under 90 seconds to play in the first half, 32-29 Gonzaga. Worth to Stockton, had to save that from going out of bounds. Now Townsend directing traffic, will dribble to the right wing, guarded by Gonzalez, crossover dribble. Townsend has Chandler Smith flashing high. Smith to the left junction to Leanne Worth, 17-footer rattles in.
That's a tough shot, and BYU defensively played that well off the pick, right there at the free throw line. Moody had to help Worth knocking it down.
Final minute of play in half number one, 5-point Gonzaga lead. Gonzalez flips to Albiero. Albiero one-handed pass over to Brenna Chase, dribbling into the right corner. Chase has Moody flashing high, cycle to Albiero, hit one three, looking for another. Big time shot from Maria Albiero, and she lets the fans know about it. 34-32.
Well, she came ready to play, especially having not knocked down a lot of three-point shots. She's shooting it confidently, taking that shot ready to shoot. BYU's going to switch everything defensively right here with under 20 seconds.
They'll send Hampson low post to guard Leanne Worth. Laura stalking out the screen of Jen Worth, picked up by Moody. Switching screens as you call for, Kristen. Three on the shot clock. Townsend with two, one, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. 6.8 to play in the half. BYU fans going nuts, and the Cougars can tie or take the lead with a shot here to most likely end half number one. Gonzaga led 19-9 after one quarter of play. BYU has fought back to within two.
Johnson will come back in the game. Smart move from Coach Judkins, getting a score in, an outside shooter, also a ball handler.
Cougars have made six of their last seven shots. They have taken much better care of the basketball here in the second quarter as well. Only one turnover. Six assists in the second quarter for BYU. 5 seconds to play. Here's Brenna Chase with four, three, cross midcourt. Johnson open for three. No, it's blocked out of bounds.
Oh, we got a foul.
By Katie Campbell, and they call
a foul.
That
was a foul. I saw the ref underneath with his arm go up, signaling a foul. Wow.
Paisley Johnson fouled by Campbell, and she's going to shoot three free throws with no time on the clock.
Watch the contact on her arm right there. Great call from the under official. That is clearly a foul, and I think everyone was so amped up that it looked like a block from whatever angle you were looking from, but lucky break for BYU.
There's one more look with time winding down. You can see 1 second to go, and yeah, that's a clear foul. Good effort by Campbell to get back and block the ball first, but her follow-through hit the arm of Johnson, And I think that the officials are checking to see if Johnson's foot was indeed behind the three-point line in that right corner to make sure she gets three free throws. If not, she'll get the two, and we'll call it a half.
Johnson for BYU, one of their better free throw shooters at 72% at the line.
Paisley Johnson leading all BYU scorers with 8 points on 3 of 7 shooting. Has a chance to get into double figures here in the first half. Now they're going to wave the BYU team back onto the floor, and they're going to put a little bit of time back here on the clock as well, saying that the whistle blew with at least one full second on the clock still. So 1 second still to play. They adjust the clock in the Marriott Center. Paisley Johnson to the line for the first of three free throws. Up and good for the 72% free throw shooter on the season, Paisley Johnson. She now has 9 points, and she's pulled BYU within one. Second free throw long, no good. One more free throw for Paisley Johnson to tie this game potentially at half. After Gonzaga led by as many as 12 at 24-12. And it rattles in. Johnson with 2 out of 3. We're tied at 34. A 25-point second quarter for BYU.
Outscoring them 25-15 here in this quarter. It was fantastic defensively. Didn't force shots. I felt like offensively they finally got into their rhythm and playing BYU basketball.
The Cougars make 6 of their final 7 shots in the second quarter and again score 25 before halftime in the most recent 10 minutes. Lauren McLean with BYU head coach Jeff Judkins.
Coach, what changed in the last few minutes of that half to allow you guys to tie it up at halftime?
I thought we were more aggressive defensively. We got some loose balls, and then we started moving the ball better. We weren't dribbling it so much. We were passing and moving it. I think we can do that because they're overplaying us. They're really shading the strong side. If we can do that, we can get some easier baskets.
Any adjustments that you feel like you need to make at halftime?
Yeah, we got to guard their guards better off the drive. We got to do a better job on the worst girls. They're hurting us in the post. We'll make some adjustments to that.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Jeff Judkins with Lauren McLean, 34 all after 20 minutes. Rice with 7 points, just one behind Laura Stockton. A balanced effort as we thought it would be from Gonzaga. Our game summary presented by Deseret First Credit Union. Deseret First, your values, your timeline, your financial future. Really, the spark for BYU was the Cougars' ability to find the range from the three-point line. That brought momentum back in, gave the defense some added motivation to play, create some steals, and here we are, tied up at half.
I think that combination with fewer turnovers in that second quarter is where they really took the edge. 25-15 for BYU in that second quarter.
8 turnovers for BYU in the first quarter, only 1 in the second quarter. Lisa Fortier has her team on a 12-game win streak. They would love nothing more than to make it 13 and hand BYU a home loss in the Marriott Center. Lauren McLean with Coach Fortier just moments ago.
Coach, BYU gained a little bit of momentum there at the end of the half. What adjustments do you need to make defensively to get the momentum back on your side?
Well, we weren't defending in that second quarter. We gave up 25 points. We weren't closing out well. We were either too slow to get to the closeout, they had the three, or we were over-closing and they were driving. I don't think we put enough ball pressure on, and they could find the lob. So really our defense went in the can, unfortunately.
Your scoring was balanced for most of that first half. What do you want to see from your team offensively in the second half?
I want to see us taking more team shots. We went one-on-one far too often. We need to work the ball side-top-side a few times, and then we can get it inside and look inside out. But we're not a one-on-one team, so we need to work for shots that come after screens and a punch and a kick and that kind of thing.
All right, thank you, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Lisa Fortier, understandably frustrated after giving up 25 points in the second quarter. Her Zags are ranked for a 6th straight week. And again with a 12-game win streak. That's the best dating back to last season when Gonzaga won 15 in a row. Correction from earlier when I said 2014. It was last season when Gonzaga won 15 straight and finished with a 17-1 mark in the regular season of the West Coast Conference.
All right, finished first. They have won 13 of the last 14 regular season titles and 7 of the last 10 tournament titles. I mean, this is tradition in this program is success. They know how to win. They have confidence. They know how to make adjustments.
Now, Lisa Fortier has a question. I'm guessing as to
possession.
Yeah, the possession right here, yeah. So now Jeff Judkins is meandering over towards this conversation between Fortier and the officials. Possession arrow is pointing in favor of Gonzaga right now.
24-4-3.
And Gonzaga apparently did not report starters, so they are going to be forced to start this half with how they ended the second quarter.
Right. I saw their coach go over and talk to the score table. So something is off here. When the half ended, he walked over to go talk to the scores table.
So technicalities in play. The officiating crew saying Gonzaga did not report starters is not about possession as we originally thought.
Right.
And they have put the 5 players for Gonzaga back out on the floor that ended the first half, which consists of Jill Townsend, who inbounds the ball to Chandler Smith. The Worth twins on the floor, as is Katie Campbell. Entry pass and a steal from Brenna Chase, and she's going to beat everyone down the floor. BYU takes the lead. And you have to imagine frustration is about ready to blow forth from Lisa Fortier. She doesn't have the lineup she wants on the floor. Now with the dead ball, she'll be able to get Rice and Stockton back into the game.
Right, but it just throws your team off when you don't start the half how you normally start. And here's Chase being aggressive, that pesky defender like we talked about, over 2 steals per game. And then off to the races, beats everyone up the court.
36-34, BYU takes their first lead since 3-2 very early in the game. Zakira Rice to Katie Campbell, left-handed three-pointer on the way and perfect.
She is 2-for-3 in this game from distance. Shoots over 80% in WCC play from three-point. You have to find her.
That's an insane number. Jasmine Moody, entry pass to Shanae Salmon. Laura Stockton coming over weak side to help out defensively, creates a steal. Lob pass to Rice. Beautifully done, Rice! And it rolls out.
This is the game plan for Gonzaga, is push and transition. I think they went a little bit away from that in the second quarter without that ability to get there. And look at Campbell, and she just relocates. She spaces to the wing where the BYU defense loses her. And I mentioned 80%. She's shooting 80% of her shot attempts from the perimeter, not 80%, which would be outstanding. But she's a fantastic three-point specialist.
Rice misses the first free throw. One more, nearly had a three-point play. Gets the second, Gonzaga up to 38-36, 1 minute into the second half. Now some three-quarter court pressure from the Zags. Gonzalez and Moody looking to beat it. Gonzalez will go back to Moody across half court. Cycled right side, Paisley Johnson driving on Campbell to the hoop. Had an open layup. Just didn't hit it off the glass hard enough or high enough, and it's left short. Rebound Gonzaga. Leanne Worth back to Stockton. Worth one more time from Stockton. Now cycled right wing, Chandler Smith. Here's Katie Campbell off the pick straight away. Dribbles to the free throw line inside Worth. Good positioning. Her shot altered as Salmon and Moody are there defensively. And the Zags miss a layup. Here comes Shaylee Gonzalez for BYU. Back to Paisley Johnson. Brenna Chase, entry pass Salmon. Too tall, strong turnover out of bounds.
That's a good idea. That's exactly the look they want, and they want the entry pass coming from the wing. And Chase is looking for it. There was no help side. It would have been a great opportunity to score. Just too much on the pass, and Sam not moving on the airtime of the ball.
Campbell has Rice guarded by Sam. 17-foot pull-up jumper rings off. Rebound to Moody, who had a good box out on Leanne Worth. Gonzalez, once again guarded by Campbell. Here's Johnson. Johnson will dribble to the left and hand off to Gonzalez on the left wing. Gonzalez crossover dribble on Smith. Off the glass and good with the left hand. Shaylee Gonzalez.
She is so impressive off the dribble with her decision making, her ability to use her body to create that space.
Gonzalez. 7 points for Gonzalez now.
Right, she's approaching double figures, scored in double figures in every game this season.
38 all, third quarter. Rice takes Moody off the dribble right side. Moody, the block shot out of bounds. Gonzaga will retain possession.
Getting a little chippy with Moody and Rice, and Moody matches her physicality. Here's another look, last possession for BYU offensively. Help side isn't there, and it's that change of speed, the burst on the first step.
Rice guarded by Johnson. Now the double comes from Gonzalez, forcing a steal. Bad pass easily taken by Chase. Chase bounces to Gonzalez on the break. Left-handed layup up and good. Brenna Chase baiting the defense, patiently waiting for Gonzalez to fill the lane and dishes it off for an easy layup.
There is such chemistry between that trio of guards and reading each other, knowing where they're going to cut and when they're coming down the lane.
Chase fouls Stockton as she goes hard off the screen to the hoop on the right side. And Laura Stockton will shoot two free throws.
This is an excellent transition play. You see, she gets the defense to commit. Gonzalez is sprinting. First starts wide and then runs at a great angle to score.
For the moment, BYU with a two-point lead, 40-38. Laura Stockton's first free throw miss in conference play comes in game number 6 of the Zags West Coast Conference slate. You just saw it as Chase has whistled for the foul on the wrist of Stockton.
That was close. She kept her body off. Looks like she got a lot of the ball. This quicker pace is what Gonzaga wants. And BYU also plays at a quick pace. You would think that it would play in favor for the Zags, but the guard line for BYU, each of them play over about 35 minutes per game. And so very conditioned, have high endurance.
Stockton uncharacteristically misses both. BYU holds on to that two-point lead, 40-38. Cougars with possession. Gonzalez from Johnson. Here comes the screen from Salmon. Gonzalez nowhere to go, so she goes to Johnson and now takes the ball back on the left wing. Gonzalez to Moody. BYU looking to cycle that ball. And Laura Stockton is going to step into the passing lane. And at the last moment, she got out of the way. Paisley Johnson thought that was Stockton was going to knock that ball out of bounds, and so a good play by Stockton results in a turnover back to the Zags.
The first quarter, BYU really looks to get that high post catch because they needed to use that. They were trying to get the high-low look. Went away from it in the second because it was not doing them any good, and they've got to go back to the guards using the screen on the wing. Great drive by Stockton just to weave in and out of traffic.
She is the emotional and floor leader for this team. Gonzalez has the ball knocked away. And a break for BYU as they're going to call Leanne Worth for shuffling her feet as she picked up that basketball to try and get the ball out to Loetta on the break.
Loetta, one of the top perimeter defenders on this team. And you see she's putting all kinds of pressure on the freshman, trying to make it tough and wear her down.
Babalu Ugu back into the game. As Johnson. Johnson goes away from the screen of Ugu. Good pass inside. Paisley Johnson to Shalay Salmon and a foul.
What a play from Johnson. Just the awareness. She kept her ball alive. She kept the ball alive off the dribble so she could create for her teammate. And Salmon finishing. Love the reaction from Johnson.
Emotional response by Johnson. Missed free throw, and now Townsend going to run the floor and try and score it. She's fouled on her way to the hoop in transition, and she'll have a couple of free throws to try and tie it up at 42. 5:47 to play. BYU with a slim two-point margin of a lead, and here is Lauren McLean.
Jeff Judkins told me that you hear a lot about BYU's guard line, but the bigs are starting to become more of a factor for the team as well. They're making an impact by being active defensively and offensively. And Juddy told me that after the Utah loss, he challenged the bigs to step it up since they got beat inside. And if they want to win a championship, that can't happen. They've accepted the challenge and are really proving themselves. Spencer.
Thank you, Lauren. The challenge, again, has been issued to the BYU bigs. Townsend makes the second of two free throws to pull the Zags within one at 42-41. Here comes the pressure once again from the Bulldogs. Crossover dribble, Gonzalez gets around Loetta, and Gonzalez will kick out to Paisley Johnson. Open three, right corner is long. Air ball falls into the hands of Jenworth. Gives to Stockton, quickly across midcourt. Stockton, free throw line, pull-up jumper. That's short, and it's going to be ruled off BYU. Fresh shot clock. for the Zags. Stockton arguing that she got hit on that pull-up jumper. Two substitutions for the Zags as well as Chandler Smith and Zykira Rice check in to replace Leanne Wirth and Stockton. Jesse Loetta will take over a point guard for the Zags and inbound from the baseline.
Coach Portier has got nine deep in her bench, and she will rotate those four off the bench, getting fresh legs at all times.
Townsend, physical player, working her way inside on Shaylee Gonzalez, and they're going to get Gonzalez with a foul on the reach. That is her second personal foul. Fourth team foul for BYU in the quarter. One more, and the Zags will shoot two the rest of this third period. First up and good from Townsend to tie it at 42. This to give the Bulldogs the lead back, and that's good as well. Jill Townsend now with 7 points. Gonzalez with Babalu Ugu looking to beat that three-quarter court trap. Nearly a turnover by BYU. Gonzalez into the lane, has Johnson. She fakes the three this time, has Ugu from the left junction. And she'll go back out to Brenna Chase. Chase now with 12 seconds on the shot clock. To Gonzalez, free throw line extended right side. Now into the paint with the left-handed dribble, has Ugu. Good pump fake and a jump shot just inside that left junction of the paint. BYU back in front by one. Nice patience by that BYU offense, specifically Ugu. Loetta.
Right. And when she plays patient, she can be so effective. It's when she's rushed and she travels or moves her pivot feet and then getting it done defensively on the other side. Getting in front of Rice, moving on the airtime of the ball and causing the turnover.
Here is the pump fake from Ugu. And the freshman from Sao Paulo knocks it down. BYU back in front by one. We got a great game going. And it doesn't get much bigger than the man right now on the left side of your screen. John Stockton, his daughter Lara, is the starting point guard and leader of this Gonzaga team. But it's been the Gonzaga bench that has been so good this season. We're talking about balance. Almost 23 points a game on average coming off the bench.
Great. You've got Worth, Boetta, Townsend and Kempton, who come in off the bench, just as good as the starting five at scoring. So great depth with their offensive ability.
Paisley Johnson and BYU with the basketball now out of the break in a one-point lead, and they're going to get Townsend with the hip check foul. A block on Johnson as she goes down to the floor. And that'll be the second team foul on the Bulldogs. 4:36 to play in the third quarter. Reminder, the bonus changed a few seasons ago. Stands at 5 team fouls in any 10-minute period, and that puts a team on the free throw line shooting 2 for the remainder of that period. Off the screen, Johnson has Ugu, 15-foot jumper, baseline right, no good, offensive rebound, Hampson up and good. Sarah Hampson with some emotion as she grabs the offensive board and puts it back, 3-point BYU lead.
5 boards for Hampson in this game, she got 3 blocks. Along with those 4 points now. And she is a force down there. They need that presence in the paint.
Chandler Smith. Zags down 3. Ugu on the reach. And Smith fouled. She'll go to the free throw line and shoot 2 because that's the 15th foul on BYU in the third quarter.
It's going to be the 4th on Ugu. Here's a look at that offensive board. She gets good position and goes right back up.
And you see Ugu. Just enough of that arm reaching around the body of Chandler Smith. Jeff Judkins,
I think that was a little
wants an explanation.
That's going to put her on the bench for quite some time. And, you know, Moody's playing very well right now in Hampton. And it's that depth that BYU needs in the post, the combination with their guards to have the post playing well. Oh, and Cosmo Cougar just fell off his stilts.
We have a mascot down, and the officials are going to make sure that the the crutch-wearing Cosmo, to give him added height here, and get off the floor appropriately. Let's hope nothing's broken. Good grief.
That did look good. It looked like it kind of twisted his knee a little bit as he went down.
Smith knocks down both after a little bit of delay in between the first and second free throws. 46-45, BYU in front by 1. Gonzalez pressured by Campbell. Gonzalez dribbling to the right side. Campbell reaching, knocking it out of bounds. BYU basketball, 17 seconds on the shot clock. 3:46 to play in the third quarter. If you're just joining us, great to have you with us on BYU TV, wherever and however you are connected. Top two teams in the West Coast Conference going at it from the Marriott Center in Provo, Utah. The Zags have won 12 straight. BYU winners of 8 in a row. Paisley Johnson, West Coast Conference Player of the Week. Misses on the short jump shot from the right side, kind of fading away from the basket. Gonzaga with an opportunity to take the lead. Campbell for three, no good. That graces off the front of the rim. Gonzalez going right at Stockton, spins in the lane, no good, but a foul called.
Gonzalez went right at her. The freshman going right at the senior Stockton. And I didn't see a lot of contact. Watch the spin move right here.
And we're talking about ticky-tack fouls, right. One called on Ugu. I think one goes against Stockton right there.
But I don't think that's a good call right there. I think that you let that go. It was a great defensive play. She didn't contact her too much. But Gonzalez, the aggression. And that's where Coach Duncan's, I heard him say to her just a moment ago, drive on him. Just go to the basket. They're going to press you. Drive on him. But she has that ability.
Shaylee Gonzalez into double figures once again. In now all 18 games that she has played as a BYU Cougar, as a true freshman, she has scored in double figures, averaging 17.6 a game. She's at 11 now after the two free throws. She leads BYU in scoring. And an offensive foul called on Zykira Rice as Paisley Johnson was chasing after Laura Stockton. BYU basketball now with a three-point lead and 3:08 to play in the third quarter. Take a closer look at this.
Whistles have been much tighter here in the second. And she's trying to hand that off. Johnson anticipating it.
Would have gone as a BYU steal either way with the way that ball came off. Sarah Hampson screening for Paisley Johnson. Jasmine Moody battling for the basketball, and her effort will earn BYU another possession.
Moody has been all-out effort on the boards. It is finding a body, or if you're offensive end, just pursuing the basketball. She has 7 now in the game.
It's a team high for BYU. Entry pass stolen away. Big defensive stop by Gonzaga as Jen Worth got her hand in the passing lane. Katie Campbell down to the left wing to go back to Worth. Cycled over to Chandler Smith. Free throw line extended. Now Campbell coming off the screen straight away behind the back dribble to her left and Laura Stockton. Stockton looking inside for Worth. Nothing there at the moment. Back to Chandler Smith near midcourt. Smith signals in another play with 6 on the shot clock. Around Moody with 4. Chandler Smith. No good. Offensive rebound Rice. And Rice is fouled on the way back up. She'll shoot 2 free throws.
Well, BYU does an outstanding job executing defensively. Out of sorts on Gonzaga's side. And then they don't box out Zykira Rice, the best rebounder on the team. Nobody finds her and puts a body on her. She's on the free throw line getting some free points.
Zykira Rice trying to cut into the three-point BYU lead. Knocks down the first. Late third quarter, BYU up 48-46 on their home floor. Rice now one shy of double-figure scoring. Second free throw. Back rim bounces around off the top of the backboard, and the whistles blow from the officiating crew. The play is dead and counts as a missed free throw. BYU basketball still in front by 2 with 2:22 to play.
Well, Coach Fortier still arguing with the ref, I think, over the call of it going over the backboard.
Chase out of trouble to Gonzalez. Paisley Johnson takes the cycle pass from Gonzalez. Now back to Moody and Chase on the left side. Sarah Hampson wide open in the post. And you see that perimeter ball movement like we showed you at halftime and inside the play, creating the easy entry pass and layup for Sarah Hampson.
If they are patient offensively, it's making it very tough for Gonzaga. They lose sight of the defender, especially Hampson, when she cut underneath right to ball side.
Katie Campbell answers right back with a big 3.
Well, she's clutch.
Deadeye.
Huge.
Campbell now with her 3rd 3 of the game. Chase trying to respond. No good. And the rebound falls easily to Campbell. Has Chandler Smith in front of everyone. Chandler Smith running the break for the Zags. And they take the lead back 51-55. Quick points for the Bulldogs. And they take that advantage here late in the third quarter, 1:13 to play. Gonzalez picked up by Campbell. Dribbles out of trouble for the moment. Goes to Paisley Johnson on her right. Now to Brenna Chase. Chase, wild pass, tracked down by Moody. Back to Gonzalez. 3, no good. Defensive rebound to Jen Wirth, and she hands off to Laura Stockton.
Four blue jerseys in there to secure that rebound and make sure BYU doesn't have an extra possession.
Wirth to Smith. Smith driving baseline right on Gonzalez. Cut off by Hampson. Pass got away, but it's tracked down by Wirth. Now Stockton with 12 seconds on the shot clock. 40 to play in the third quarter. Stockton crossover dribble on Chase, and they're going to get Chase with the body. Laura Stockton so good at using her body and her physical style of play to get to the hoop and create free throw opportunities.
Right. Aside from Jessie Loetta, she's one of the shorter players on this team, as you see her parents, but she's very physical, probably one of the most physical players on this team. She's a bruiser. She's going to go in there and just fight until she can get a shot off and battle, and if you're going to foul her, she's going to take you to the rim.
Stockton had some tape on her fingers, and after she missed a third consecutive free throw, pulled part of that off and threw it towards her bench, clearly bothered by how it's affecting her shot. And that free throw is good. Gonzaga up two, 52-50, 39 seconds to play in the third quarter. Stockton will check out. Jessie Loetta to come in and help out defensively. Maria Albiero also in for BYU. She knocked down two huge threes for the Cougars in the first half to help BYU erase a 12-point deficit. Brenna Chase to Jasmine Moody on her left. Moody on the left wing. Looking inside, that pass is too tall for Salmon. And now an opportunity for the Zags to build on their two-point lead. Smith into the lane, has it ripped away by Paisley Johnson. 16 seconds to play now. Johnson across midcourt, and BYU, if they choose, can hold for the last shot. Albiero with nine. Now eight, signaling a play. Now six, Albiero off the screen. It's four, three, bounces to Moody. Three-pointer straightaway blocked and falls into the hands of Jen Wirth. Some offensive miscues, both by Gonzaga and BYU late in the third quarter. We'll go to the into the fourth quarter. Gonzaga with a 52-50 lead on BYU, the 13th ranked Zags, being led by their senior point guard Laura Stockton. 11 points on 3 of 5 shooting, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 steals. Shaylee Gonzalez equaling that with 11 points, 5 rebounds of her own, and also 2 assists. Our game summary presented by Deseret First Credit Union. Deseret First, your values, your timeline, your financial future. Been a very fun point guard matchup to watch tonight, with a senior and true freshman going head-to-head. Gonzalez will start the fourth quarter on the bench. Maria Albiero in running the point guard duties for the Cougars.
And Gonzalez was pretty gassed. She wasn't able to catch Smith on a wide-open transition, and then that's where you have to sit her, even though you don't want to. You need fresh legs here in the fourth.
Brenna Chase skip pass to Albiero. A dribble top of the key and a steal by Smith. Smith right at Paisley Johnson. Layup too strong. Albiero corrals the rebound, and she's got two wide open teammates with Brenna Chase cherry picking after that turnover. BYU fortunate right there to tie this game up at 52.
Oh, I love the heads up play from Albiero. She hustled back to secure that rebound, kept her head on the swivel, eyes up, and found Chase.
Jill Townsend to Jessie Loetta. Loetta directing traffic on the floor off the screen of Leanne Wirth into the paint. Has Kempton open from the left side, and the freshman out of Idaho with a big jump shot to give the Bulldogs a two-point lead right back. Albiero to Johnson right side. Takes it back, does Albiero, and will continue the two-man game with Johnson. Trying to go at Chandler Smith. Cut off nicely defensively by the Gonzaga senior guard. Chase to Moody straight away. Eight on the shot clock. Moody dribbling around Leanne Wirth. Jasmine Moody off the glass. Well, not typically do we see Jasmine Moody put the ball on the floor and go high to low all on her own and go glass.
Well, she's got to be an offensive threat. Every team that's going to play against her is either going to sag up or just put pressure on her because they know she won't put the ball on the floor. She's capable, as we saw right there, be a threat.
Chase, as Townsend goes inside and draws contact on Shalay Salmon with the blocking foul.
Salmon had rotated over on the drive, that help side first line of defense. Here's another look. Look at all the pressure from Wirth. Put the ball on the floor, use Salmon for a screen a little bit as she was posting up.
Townsend's first free throw is good. Gonzaga back in front by one. Now, mass substitutions from Lisa Fortier on the Bulldogs side. A trio Bulldog players will come back in. Zykira Rice, Jen Wirth, and Laura Stockton all in. 8-11 to play in the game. Townsend makes the second free throw, 56-54. Our scorebox sponsor tonight, Brady Industries, a provider of commercial cleaning supplies and equipment. Albiero across midcourt, Shaylee Gonzalez getting ready to check back in, or is now back in for BYU, back on the floor. Ugu as well for the Cougars. Now Ugu looking for some help, hands it off to Gonzalez with 12 on the shot clock. Loetta pressuring defensively. Here's Albiero. Screen. Albiero into a jump shot. How big has Maria Albiero been off the bench for BYU?
She's been fantastic. Averages 3 points per game. She's got 8 in this one.
Tied at 56. Rice going at the freshman. Ugu forces that shot up, and she has a foul call. More free throws on the way for the Bulldogs.
And if that is Ugu, she's going to foul out of this game. Yep, that is her fifth. Here's another look, that pull-up jumper. That is her sweet spot, little mid-range pull-up. And that's unfortunate because I think she is one of the better scoring posts for BYU. It just has not been her night. She's been in foul trouble.
Babalu Ugu starting tonight for BYU, but again with the foul trouble, we'll check out now. Jasmine Moody didn't get much of a break, but Moody back in for the Cougars in this critical final 7 minutes, 28 seconds. Sarah Hampson also back in. Shalay Salmon is going to take a break as Jeff Judkins is going to move some pieces around to try and preserve his bigs and let each of them catch their breath.
And now he's just rotating those three rather than having Ugu in the mix. And Rice did the right thing, just going at her, drawing the contact.
Rice makes the first free throw. Gonzaga back in front by one. Lauren McLean, what do you have for us?
In between quarters, one of the things Jeff Judkins said to his team was they need to stop fouling. He said it's all free throws for the Zags right now, so stop bailing them out. We've been in this situation before. Let's finish strong and let's stop fouling. Spencer.
All right, we'll see if the Cougars can adhere their coach's instruction. Gonzaga, meanwhile, showing pressure. BYU into their offensive set now. With Paisley Johnson to Moody. Albiero dribbles back straight away to the free throw line. Cut off. Now Gonzalez with 8 seconds on the shot clock. Right wing off the screen of Hampson. She's doubled inside to Hampson. Back out to Johnson with 3. Paisley Johnson inside. Moody off the glass. And a foul! With 1 second left on the shot clock.
Tremendous patience from BYU. Shot clock's going down. Johnson didn't force the shot. Finds Moody. Good position down low.
How about the no look from Paisley Johnson? Oh!
It's the ball movement for BYU. When they move that ball and they get a couple reversals, the defense really has to work.
Back and forth we go in the fourth quarter. Moody to give BYU the lead. Free throw miss, so we stay tied at 58.
Big discrepancy as we go back to Lauren's point with the foul shooting is Gonzaga 25 attempts to free throw line, BYU just 13.
Gonzaga shooting 68% from the free throw line. Wide open, Rice finds Jen Wirth underneath. Miscommunication defensively by BYU, and the Zags take the lead once again.
Moody double-teamed Rice, which is the game plan, but she's too far off of the block. You can't double-team that and expect Paisley Johnson to drop and help out.
Brenna Chase thought about a three for a moment. Now she'll step back into a deep shot. Not a great shot selection. Saved back in by Jasmine Moody to Sarah Hampson. Back to Chase. Now to Gonzalez for 3. That's good! What an effort by Moody to save that ball in. Gonzaga kind of gave up on it, thinking that BYU was just going to let it go out. Last second hesitation, allowing BYU to retain possession, and Gonzalez gives the Cougars back the lead by 1. Zykira Rice, how about that pass inside? But the shot is altered. Offensive rebound, Townsend, block shot, Hampson. Hampson fouls Rice on a third attempt by the Zags, and Rice flexes after that. Makes, she'll go to the free throw line.
These O boards for both teams are what is coming up big. Late in the shot clock, shot goes up, you don't box out. Townsend stays with it, then Rice stays with it. We saw the same thing on the other end.
Gonzaga now leading by 1. Rice to make it a 2-point lead. Free throw in and out. Rebound by Jasmine Moody. Quickly outlets to Gonzalez. Gonzalez to Chase, right wing. Chase into the lane. Now kicks out to Paisley Johnson, who dribbles straight away. Now to the right side. Johnson Pass inside is altered, and a critical turnover right there. The 17th of the game by BYU, and Gonzaga with the one-point lead and the ball. 5:33 to play in the game in Provo. Stockton off the screen of Rice has Loetta coming off a pick. Bounce inside to Rice. Pretty move. And that'll be BYU basketball as Jen Worth was out of bounds when she touched the ball on that loose rebound effort, giving it back to the Cougars.
Rice had all kinds of time down there to make a move, gain position, and Worth clearly out of bounds as they both were touching it. That's a good call.
Timeout on the floor. 5:23 to play. Gonzaga, ranked 13th in the country. They have won 12 games in a row in Provo with the slimmest of leads, 62-61 over BYU, who's trying to win their ninth straight. Stay with us. Here, Cassie Broadhead from a few seasons ago, now expecting her first child. Congratulations to Cassie and her husband. I should say Cassie DeVajer.
DeVajer, right? Travis DeVajer.
It's formerly Cassie Broadhead. So yeah, our shout out to Cassie and Travis as they're ready to become parents. Cassie watching BYU take on Gonzaga, down by one, just over 5 minutes to play in the game. It's been very entertaining. Gonzaga out to a quick start, led 24-12, had a 10-point lead after one quarter, and then BYU worked their way back into it in the second quarter. 5 minutes even to play now, 7 on the shot clock for BYU. Brenna Chase driving on Chandler Smith with 2. She got to put it up. She will, and knocks it down!
Home court advantage right there. Used to shoot some of those shots in practice maybe on these hoops. Gonzaga came out of the timeout in a different defense, went zone to mix it up.
The Bulldogs did everything right there defensively, and Brenna Chase just hit a tough shot. Now a traveling call on the Bulldogs. Turnover. Back to BYU, the 14th of the game by Gonzaga, as Brenna Chase bails out the Cougars with the shot clock winding down. 4:33 to play, another timeout. BYU now back in front. Don't go anywhere.
Minute to pass it, so the defense commits. Once again, the movement. And then creating that shot down low for Hampson. They've been very good at drawing that double team and then kicking. And this was with 1 second on the shot clock. Kicks to Moody, picks up the foul for an and one. When they're patient and they don't force the situation into those turnovers, force it down low, that's when they've been very successful in executing.
4:30 to play in the game. BYU with the ball and a one-point lead on their home floor, trying to win their ninth straight game. This would unquestionably be their signature win of the season against 13th-ranked Gonzaga. And look at Hampson play the give-and-go game with Chase.
That play was drawn up at the timeout, executed perfectly. Gonzaga did not anticipate Chase running off of Hampson.
3-point BYU lead, 65-62, 4 minutes to play. Katie Campbell behind the back dribble goes to Jen Worth on the baseline. Look at that pretty reverse layup by Worth.
Goes right under the basket, using that essentially as a screen so Hampson cannot block her shot. Big time shot from Worth.
This is the first real adversity Gonzaga has faced in a while. Their closest game in conference play came against St. Mary's, an 8-point win over the Gales. They trail by one. Paisley Johnson trying to make it a 4-point lead for BYU. No good. Battle for the rebound. They're going to say it's off Jasmine Moody. It'll be Gonzaga basketball, and the Bulldogs will have a chance to take the lead back with 3:33 to go.
Here's a look at Chase right here. Smith turned her head to see where the ball went. Chase taking advantage with the back cut.
Chase with 14 points, Gonzalez with 14, Johnson with 10. The big three for BYU all in double figures. Zykira Rice leading Gonzaga with 13, Laura Stockton with 11. Here is Katie Campbell to give Gonzaga the lead, and it falls off. Zykira Rice, look at that effort to create another opportunity for the Zags.
8th offensive rebound for Gonzaga, BYU with 9. But the Zags have been more efficient at scoring when they get the second chance opportunity.
Chandler Smith, left corner. 3 minutes to go. BYU leading by one, 65-64. Laura Stockton, entry pass there. Hampson knocks it out of play. And Zykira Rice chasing it down. Out of bounds. Turnover, BYU basketball. Sarah Hampson has been an absolute disruptor.
That length really imposes problems on both sides, defensively, offensively. I talked to Coach Fortier before this game, and she said, we have a 6'5 player, practice player, that comes in. He's not normally allowed to block shots. But leading up to this game, he was allowed to block shots, anticipating the length of Sarah Hampson.
BYU basketball, 1-point lead. Johnson picks up her dribble, going baseline right, has Gonzalez. Jumper on the way, no good, but a foul called as Shaylee goes down to the floor. Two shots coming. That is the fourth foul on Laura Stockton.
Good cut from Gonzalez. Paisley Johnson was stuck. So coming to the ball, maybe got her on kind of that checkout, not allowing the shooter to land. And that's, I mean, four fouls on Stockton. This is a very tight game. Even if we go to overtime, she's got to be very careful.
Gonzalez now with 15 points after she makes the first free throw. Perfect on the second. She has a game-high 16. 4-for-4 from the free throw line. 5 rebounds, 2 assists. 3-point BYU lead, 67-64. 2:23 to play. Rice on Hampson. Block shot, Hampson! BYU fans on their feet. Shaylee Gonzalez with the ball for the Cougars.
Don't rush it right here. Use some of this clock. They got to be patient. Hampson with 4 blocks on an outstanding stuff on Rice.
Gonzalez thought about a three for a moment. 13 on the shot clock. Paisley Johnson off the screen from Salmon. Straight away. Now has another screen. Pick, pop, short. Rebound Chandler Smith. Big stop by the Zags. Smith across the timeline. Ball poked away from the moment. Tracked down by Stockton. And she's back towards midcourt with 1:40 to go in the game. Fortier wants a timeout for Gonzaga to calm her side down. And we'll take another look at Sarah Hampson's swat on Zykira Rice. You will get nothing and like it.
She just kept her feet down, stayed in position, didn't foul her. You can't anticipate that length any better from Rice. And she was trying to go up into her, trying to draw contact. I love what Hampson has done in this game. She's been a difference maker.
BYU trying to snap Gonzaga's 12-game win streak. The Bulldogs are ranked higher than they've ever been in program history at number 13. It has been a steady climb as they have worked their way to a 16-1 record. Best start also in program history. They are loaded with talent, loaded with experience. They knew they were in for a battle in Provo.
And they come in with a 10 RPI, the rating. And that just showed you who they played, the strength of their schedule, how tough it has been to be at 16-1.
Beat Stanford in Spokane. Played number one ranked Notre Dame competitively. That's their only loss. Trying to avoid loss number two here against BYU. Laura Stockton, good fake. Up and under, off the glass and good. What a move by the senior point guard to pull the Bulldogs within one.
Almost a foot difference right there, and she just used her patience in the paint, good footwork to take Hampson.
67-66, timeout Jeff Judkins and BYU. One more look at Laura Stockton's clutch move in the paint. Gets underneath Hampson with that shoulder fake and up for an easy layup. She's got 13 points, tied for a team high lead with Zykira Rice.
They're two senior leaders. That is who you want the ball. You want the ball in their hand. You want them making the plays. You look at her parents.
John and Nada Stockton watching on in the Marriott Center. 1 minute, 12 seconds to play. Gonzaga has cut the BYU lead back down to one. And a reminder, our women's basketball coverage will continue this Saturday as the Cougars host the Portland Pilots, 4 Eastern, 2 Mountain Time, live on BYU TV. I'll be here, as will Kristen Kozlowski. But we're all awaiting the final 72 seconds of the matchup of the season today here in West Coast Conference women's basketball between BYU, first place in conference, 6-0, Gonzaga, second place, 5-0. But the Zags, a favorite, obviously, is the 13th ranked team in the country and have won 12 overall. Gonzalez guarded by Campbell. Pressured and now goes to Johnson. Johnson around Stockton. She's fouled, going up for the left-handed layup by Rice.
ISO for Johnson. And they're trying to target Stockton. She cannot foul or she's out of the game. Johnson attacked, did her job, and picks up that foul. That's a huge drive to the basket, putting her on the line.
Johnson, as the BYU fans fall silent, makes her first free throw. 11 points for Paisley Johnson. 3 of 13 shooting, but she has made big plays with the assists and defensively for the Cougars and makes two huge free throws right there. Final minute, 69-66, BYU. Here we go. Laura Stockton, left wing, has Rice in the post off the screen of Leanne Worth. Straight away, Stockton picked up by Moody as BYU switches the pick. Leanne Worth on Moody. Shot no good. And they're going to call a foul, I believe, on the rebound on Sarah Hampson over the back of Zykira Rice. That is the call. That is the fourth team foul on BYU, so no bonus situation. Gonzaga will inbound on the baseline with Laura Stockton, but not before a timeout.
Rice had the position. That is a good call. Watch the hand go over the head of Rice. Great box out, and that's her. She gets in position, uses her body well to try to secure that rebound. BYU has made it very tough for her. She only has two boards in this game. She comes in averaging close to 7 rebounds.
Gut check time for Gonzaga, trailing by 3, 45 seconds to play. They have paraded through West Coast Conference play thus far. They beat Portland by 26, Pacific by 23, the aforementioned 8-point win against St. Mary's, Pepperdine by 25, Loyola Marymount by 25, and have pushed the win streak to 12, BYU with 8 consecutive wins after the Cougars won 2 close, hard-fought road games before coming back to host Gonzaga tonight.
This win gives either team a lot of momentum and confidence going forward. This is a huge win for either one of these teams.
BYU won at St. Mary's by 1 in their last game last Saturday, 74-73. Won at Pacific by 3, 77-74. If the Cougars can get past Gonzaga, and that is a large if here tonight, they'll be a heavy favorite against Portland before going on the road to San Diego and LMU. 45 seconds to go. Stockton to inbound on the baseline. Gonzaga trailing BYU by 3. Stockton lobs it into Rice. Straightaway 3-point land. Stockton driving at Hampson into the paint. Her pass knocked down. Tracked down once again by Stockton. Has Moody, and she floats it up and in. Laura Stockton. 35 seconds to play.
She's a workhorse in there. Had it stolen almost twice, maybe 3 times. Had it blocked once. And just stuck with it over Jasmine Moody.
Teardrop floater from the senior point guard. Big time play. And we'll have another timeout as the chess match continues between the Cougars and the Bulldogs here. BYU obviously with the ball and the 1-point lead, but Gonzaga right now guaranteed to get the ball back with at least 6 seconds to play in this game. There are 3 team fouls on the Zags, so they do have the opportunity to see what BYU is going to do and then commit a foul, perhaps call another timeout and reset. That said, it would reset the shot clock.
Right, so I don't think I would do that. Because right now you do have those 6 seconds differential. Just buckle down and play defense. They're going to come out with some pressure on BYU, some of their top defenders. Loetta's in the game. Smith is a good defender in Stockton, but she is playing with those 4 fouls. I think if you're BYU, you attack whoever Stockton is guarding.
Maria Albiero into the game. Some extra ball handling on the floor for the Cougars. Full court pressure. And they're going to say Gonzaga basketball. Did that go off of Loetta?
They're
going to
review.
BYU?
They'll review this because it's under a minute.
That ball was tipped on the pass inside. We'll take a closer look. Loetta got a fingertip on that. That goes off the hand of Paisley Johnson. That's going to be Gonzaga basketball. What a play by Loetta.
Tremendous. I mean, she just stayed right in front of Johnson, knew that flash was coming, and it was rushed. I didn't think they needed the flash. They didn't wait long enough for the guard split.
Momentum shifting in a hurry back in favor of the Zags. 35.2 to play in the game. Officials reviewing to make sure it was called Gonzaga basketball as it was tipped by Loetta with the left hand. And you see the left hand extended from BYU's Paisley Johnson as well. And that is clearly off of the taped thumb of Paisley Johnson and should be Gonzaga basketball.
Great play defensively from Loetta. I like the pressure that they came out with. Just a heads-up play. I think that they reviewed it and know that it went off Johnson, but they're also taking into account how much time went off the clock. So reviewing that possibly as well.
BYU led by 369-66 with 45 seconds to play. Lara Stockton nearly had the ball stolen from her. Fought through the struggle down low. Floated in a beautiful shot to pull the Zags within one. They called a timeout, set up their full court pressure, and now have created a turnover by BYU, which would be the Cougars' 18th of the game.
All they had to do is get that ball in bounds and get it up the court. Now they're in a very tough situation where they have to play solid defense, not foul. BYU women's volleyball looking on.
Kennedy Eschenberg on the left side, part of that magical volleyball run that went to the Final Four in Minneapolis for BYU, ultimately ending at the hands of the national champion Stanford. Couple of projected NCAA tournament teams going head-to-head here. Gonzaga with the ball after review. Lara Stockton and the Bulldogs trying to take the lead back from BYU. Stockton out the screen from Rice. Pass knocked down by Chase. Rice tracks it down, gives it back to Stockton. Stockton at Hampson. Layup, no good. Rebound, Jasmine Moody. Foul called. And that'll be the fourth team foul on Gonzaga. So BYU will need to inbound here with 21 seconds to play in the game.
Foul was called on Leanne Worth over the back on the rebound. Watch again right here. Stockton going at Campson, kept her body off, altered the shot, and see the foul right there. A great call by the officials right on top of it as Moody was trying to secure that rebound.
BYU dodges a major bullet after turning it over. The Zags had the ball with a chance to go back up in front. Stockton misses the layup, and now a foul called on Leanne Worth over the back, crashing into Jasmine Moody. It is not a free throw situation for BYU, so again, the Cougars will have to inbound successfully, and then the foul game begins for the Bulldogs.
Both teams with four team fouls, so one more, and they're on the free throw line. And go back to just a moment ago where BYU could get the ball inbounds and turn it over. They've got to be able to get that ball inbounds. I would utilize Hampson right here. Let her flash and get that ball because of her height if you're struggling to get it in.
BYU will put on the floor their ball handling crew. Brenna Chase, Paisley Johnson, Shaylee Gonzalez, Maria Alviera, one big, Jasmine Moody in the post, but the four guards.
So Hampson out. They won't be using her, and that's probably a good idea as well because of the ball handling that you need to take care of the ball.
If Gonzaga can foul Jasmine Moody, they should. Inbounded to Albiero. Leanne Worth. As Albiero throws a pass to Moody. Back out to Gonzalez. 13 seconds to play. Gonzalez is going to be fouled with Loetta. And Worth near midcourt. That'll send Shaylee Gonzalez to the free throw line with a chance to put BYU up two, maybe three, if she can knock both in.
She's a 71.4% free throw shooter coming into this game. 4-for-4 in the game at the charity stripe.
She leads BYU in free throw attempts this season with 63 entering tonight's game. And as you mentioned, Kristen, with those four, now a 67 attempts. That's attempt number 68, and it's short. Gonzalez with one more, 13 seconds to play.
BYU with no timeouts left. Gonzaga with that one.
Gonzalez gets the roll. BYU leading 70-68. Gonzaga will now have the option to play for the tie or the win here.
They have not shot the three ball particularly well. 3-for-7 in the game. That's not their strength. look for them to really attack the basket like they've been doing, whether it's Stockton or one of the other guards. And if the double team comes, they're going to kick it to the high post catch.
Katie Campbell is the three-point threat for Gonzaga. So
no help off Campbell.
Anticipate that she will be on the floor and BYU will play her face up.
You'd rather give up a two than a three-point shot. And that's something that the BYU players just have to be aware of. It's okay to give up a two. Obviously, you don't want to, but over a three. Don't give up a three-point shot or foul on the three.
You mentioned the 3-for-7 percentage-wise, 43, not bad. Gonzaga just doesn't shoot a ton of three-pointers because they have such great balance inside with Rice and the Worth twins, not to mention Stockton off the dribble getting to the basket. They have plenty of offensive weapons and plays to implement here with the 13 seconds to play. Two-point BYU lead over 13th-ranked Gonzaga. 70-68, the Cougars trying to end the Bulldogs' 12-game win streak. Fans in the Marriott Center on their feet. Chandler Smith to inbound goes to Laura Stockton with 10 seconds. Stockton guarded by Chase, looking for Zykira Rice. Rice back to Stockton with 4. Three-pointer up, no good. Rebound Leanne Worth at the buzzer, no good! BYU wins!
Judkins' face says it all right now. He was full-fisted, running out there, so excited, just as his team is. What a huge victory for BYU. Number 13th-ranked Gonzaga goes down. The 12-game win streak broken.
BYU moves to 15-3 on the season. They're 7-0 in the West Coast Conference. They've won 9 games in a row overall. And now, it would seem, have put themselves in prime position to earn an at-large spot in the NCAA tournament.
That definitely helps. Like coming into this, they have a 28 RPI, and so that's a decent RPI, really good. A huge win now on their profile.
Down goes 13th-ranked Gonzaga, Jasmine Moody. Our AAA MVP of the game tonight, brought to you by AAA. What does your insurance do when it's not doing insurance? It should do more. Learn more at AAA.com. 6 points, 10 top rebounds, a block, a steal, and a massive defensive presence inside.
She was a game changer for this team. Those numbers aren't glaring and over the top, but her defense and her ability to be in there and be a presence in the paint, that was a difference in the game.
Hugs all around for BYU women's basketball. Jasmine Moody is with Lauren McLean.
Jasmine, down goes number 13 Gonzaga, and you guys remain undefeated in conference play. How were you able to get the win tonight?
We just played awesome defense. We listened to what Jody said and executed his plan, and it just worked out in our favor. So we're so excited.
And you were our game changer. You had 6 points and 10 rebounds. What was your mentality coming into the game tonight?
I just knew that their bigs were what was going to stop us, so I needed to play my hardest, and that's what I did. So just rebound for the team. That's my role.
When you see one of your fellow bigs, Sarah Hampson, get a huge block there down the stretch, what impact does that make on the game?
It was a huge impact. Sarah is one of our key players, and without her, I mean, that could have went in, so it was awesome.
What do you feel like you can take from this game moving forward?
I think that with this win, we're going to be conference champs, so.
I love it. Congratulations. Thanks, Jasmine.
Thank you so much.
Spence.
Thank you, Lauren, and thank you, Jasmine. Congratulations to